Pakistanis, they always bring this issue with the Indians. They say India should be the part of the trilateral or the triangle that we have in that region. They think that the peace cannot be achieved unless the United States and the international community address the core issues within the region, including the Kashmir issue. And I'm sure when you were in Pakistan, that must have been brought up in front of you too. So what do you think? I mean, this is something that in Congress or privately, if not the government itself, the Americans should be paying attention to?
Well, first of all, we respect the sovereignty of all nations. And I do believe that South Asia is an important region, and it includes not only India, but Bangladesh. Other surrounding areas. In this instance, both Afghanistan and Pakistan agreed to engage in this alliance, and they had unique and particular issues as relates to an ongoing war in Afghanistan. India is a sovereign nation. Nothing prevents the three countries or the region itself from having its own bilaterals. We encourage that, and as we begin to look at further ways of encouraging and working with India and Pakistan and looking at some of the very difficult issues that they have together. The United States, I believe, and members of the United States Congress certainly don't mind discussing these issues and being a force for opportunity for engagement. But it is not the position of the United States, not the position, let me say, of, I believe, my colleagues to force a sovereign nation to engage in a particular structure that is now presently used for discussions between Pakistan and Afghanistan. We encourage dialogue, we encourage the ability to resolve these issues, and I would simply say that I would look forward to seeing Pakistan, India, Afghanistan, and Bangladesh engage in regional discussions.
What do you think is the feeling in Congress about a nuclear civilian deal for the Pakistanis as well on the pattern of the Indians?
Well, I know that we all need energy, and certainly this issue has been raised, but it would be too premature for me to make any speculative comments about what would be the next steps. I know that from the funding, the $7.5 billion that will be in the mix for Pakistan, there are many discussions about energy and what forms of energy and how it will be generated. I think there are many opportunities to encourage energy resources and provide energy resources for the Pakistani people. And I think we should look at those many, many options, but also see the opportunity that may come about through this new surge of dollars that has been gifted by the American people.
Would you yourself look at this proposal favorably if it comes up for consideration in Congress for a civilian nuclear deal for Pakistan?
I think it's important for me not to speak prematurely. I'm a friend of Pakistan. We have a number of members who are friends of Pakistan. And I would say in that instance, count us as having all ears to be able to look at all proposals that might be coming forward, including building a full-fledged hospital that would add to the needs of the Pakistani people.
Congressman, during your visit, I'm sure that the issue of drone attacks must have been discussed with the leaders, with the leadership, the civilian as well as the military, and the people of Pakistan, the private citizens. What do you think of this issue? How they, what you, when you came back, what was your feeling of this this issue, the drone attacks?
Well, again, we're always open to listening to our allies, and there's no doubt that you hear of the positions of the government that are made when you visit. As well, I listen to the positions of the United States government and as well some of the very difficult concerns that are there as it relates to people who are hiding in the frontier area of Pakistan. The need to protect the people, the need to end terrorism, and the need to really end locating of terrorist groups in the frontier area. Now, let me just say this. There is no desire for innocent loss of life by any of us. I think it's important that we continue to dialogue. And again, I think it's important for the American people to be looked at holistically, not on one issue. It would be, I think, a very good moment I know that officials are very busy when they come to the United States on a number of occasions, but I think it's important for the officials who are leading government to engage directly with members of Congress as they come to expand their dialogue on a number of the issues that they've raised. I look forward to invitations that I've shared with the leadership to come not only into Washington area, but to visit cities outside the Washington area. I think it's important for us to engage with the leadership of Pakistan, for people to know of their commitment in fighting the war on terror, of the sacrifice that many in their military have made, and then we'll have an opportunity to look at many, many issues. But we should all be defined not by one issue, but by the collective good that we're trying to do.
The Obama administration's administration feels that the support for al-Qaeda has waned, and they themselves have weakened the members around the world, actually, and they haven't been successful to launch anything very substantive around the world. And also, the Pakistani government believes that the Taliban, they don't have the means, the resources to launch attacks outside Pakistan and Afghanistan. So do you concur with this position?
Let me say that I don't view the war on terror as having starts and stops. We have franchise terrorism where there are people operating alone in terms of the action, but in essence they may have a support system that is behind them. I believe the United States has worked sincerely and consistently and trying to fight off terrorists that would not only be attacking the United States, but many people around the world. There are countless lost lives in Pakistan alone because of terrorist acts. I'm saddened for their families and for the loss, and for the loss to the Pakistan people. They should understand that our concern about al-Qaeda, our concern about the Taliban who would train individuals to come to the United States and kill innocent Americans, is as much a concern about the killing of innocent people in Pakistan. We have to work together to recognize that there is a challenge to the world's sovereignty, to people who love democracy around the world. And if we can all achieve that one goal, that we have a common basis, again, we can look at each other through different glasses, we can look at each other as having more of a well-rounded perspective. That perspective is that we care about the human being, the growth of the human being, the educating of children, the rights of women, the environment, the health care, but we also have to work on fighting terrorist activities around the world.